Chatty friends from around the world, hello, and welcome to a new Chashi lesson with me, Stefan Erler, from the Tea Masters blog. And today we are going to do something yet different. This time I've dressed more Chinese clothes, because I'm going to do a very traditional tea preparation called the Chaozhou Gong Fu Cha. Many of you probably have heard about it, but it's rarely performed nowadays. And for this purpose, I have lit my charcoal in my Nilu. It's already quite hot. The water is coming to a boil, so I'm putting it now to rest a little bit on one that is not lit with charcoal. So if I don't have enough charcoal, I can add more like this. But so far so good. Let it rest a bit. There are a few things to do before we start to brew. So Chaozhou Gong Fu Cha requires a little Yixing teapot or Shanto teapot can also be used. The teapot is called the Chashi, and the plate for the three cups is called the Chadian. And of course we'll have our Cha Tuo, and very important, we need our tea from our pewter tea caddy. Let me get the leaves. So for Chaozhou Gong Fu Cha, the best is to use Wuyi tea. This is most traditional. We could also use Baozhong or Roasted Shuixian, Danzong Shuixian. Now I'm going to use Wuyi Shuixian from 2019. Okay, let's see if it's enough or not. Quite a lot of leaves, but this is the idea with Chaozhou Gong Fu Cha, to use lots of leaves to get something very strong, but in small quantity. Now, my water is still steaming. Put it back. Now to start, very important, always preheat the teapot. Now we start on the outside. Then the inside. Today is a bit cold, so we have a very nice steam coming out. We can even add more. All around the teapot. Oh, beautiful, beautiful. Now comes a first difference with traditional chashi. I would usually pour the hot water in the cups, but no, for Chaozhou Gong Fu Cha, you add the cups here behind the teapot, and with your fingers you turn the cups and they get pretty warm. Hopla. And you also do this with this last third cup. Et voilà. Of course, we can still preheat them also this way. Like this, they'll stay warm a longer time. But here, the difference is the edges are not warmed. When you put them inside the chashi here, they get warmed on the edges. So it's more complete way of creating it. Now, smells very good. There's also a technique for the leaves. You'll start maybe with 1/3 of the leaves, and you want to break them a bit, make them smaller in your hand, so that they'll take less space inside the teapot. Otherwise, you are not able to put all so many leaves in the teapot. And also, breaking the leaves, 1/3 of the leaves, is one way to increase the concentration, because these broken leaves will release their tea much faster, much stronger than a whole leaf. Okay, that's pretty a lot. It's steaming hot now. Oh, since it's going to be very quick, I'm going to empty my cups first. Oops. And oh, the water is a bit too hot. And some more. I'm going to put it here since it's so hot. Now, remember, it should be quite strong already, because we have broken 1/3 of the leaves and we have really used a lot of leaves in this tiny Yixing Juni teapot with a flat shape to make it more harmonious with the shape of the leaves. Okay. Now, still steaming. Voilà. Excellent smell. And excellent taste. So again, you take small sips to taste tea, even though the cups are quite small. But still, the tea is very concentrated, so you are appreciating by taking very small sips. Very nice. It starts quite light and fresh, but then it builds, and the aftertaste now is very, very pleasant. This is an amazing tea, very high quality. Since you could not come, I have to drink all these cups by myself. Excellent. The roast on this Juicien was very well done. Not too strong, even on the first brew. I already have a very nice natural forest kind of and flower scents. Very nice. Now my water is still hot. Well, what should we do? I've lost a little bit of water by preheating and by making one brew, so I'm adding a little bit more. Not too much at a time, otherwise it might take too long to warm. So to heat it again, to get it to a boil again, I have to place it on the Nilu. And while it's while I'm waiting for this to get hot and boiling, I can enjoy my third cup of tea. So traditionally, the Chajo Gongfu Cha uses three porcelain cups called Zhoushan Bei, Zhoushan being the creator of the cups, roughly in that shape. The porcelain should be very thin to increase the finesse and the refinement of the aromas. Now, this is really a top top experience. You don't get to use charcoal to boil your water and then drink such a nice oui every day. It's really a treat. Let's prepare for a second brew. If you think that the water is not getting warm quickly enough, or that the charcoal is a bit slow, you can increase the airflow with a fan. This should help to make the water boil faster. I'm using a silver Usu Wei, a silver kettle, today because of its thin walls and high heat conductivity. So water in the silver tip, silver kettle will warm up faster. It's easier than therefore to handle compared to a Tetsubin. Tetsubin has much more entropy, so there's a lot of heat that will be accumulated by the iron, and sometimes it's a little bit more tricky to heat on charcoal than silver. Now traditionally they were using pottery kettles. But the silver has a much more pure taste than pottery kettle, so just using silver for this occasion now. I see a bit more steam coming out. I guess it's roughly okay. Yeah. When I see all this steam, I think it should be okay. Voilà. Okay, second brew is done. Still very, very nice. Oh, yeah, still steam coming out. Let me. You always have to check on the charcoal, so it's you have to pay attention to both the charcoal and the tea. So here I think I could add some more charcoal again. Now I misplaced. I have some metal chopsticks called huokuai. But I could not find them, so I'm using this instead. Okay. And I'm adding a bit more water. Beautiful. Now you've noticed something else is that I've left my hot water in the chashi, in this bowl, to keep the teapot even warmer, and I can again use it now between brews to rinse or clean my cups again. Or preheat them. Now there's an etiquette for the cups. Yeah. Okay, now they are gliding. So you can touch them on the outside, but not on the inside with your fingers. Huh? And this one, and very beautiful, the aftertaste lingers very gently and with power. It's a very, very comfortable feeling, very beautiful oolong sweetness, but the ooey sweetness is a bit different from the Taiwanese sweetness. It has this additional mineral feeling, so this rocky feeling, and it creates a salivation on the tongue that is very, very nice. But I must say this one is really very well roasted, because I barely notice the roast. It's already very natural aromas that are getting on my tongue and in my palate. Mm. So not only do I have the music from the guqin, but I also have the music from the charcoal making some cracking, the glow, and also a bit the scent of this charcoal being burnt. Of course, as you can see, there is there's no flame, so the water is boiling simply thanks to the heat of the charcoal, which is incandescent, difficult to say. So it's more infrared type of heat source, which is gentle, and if you use a good charcoal, it will have also a sweet taste that somehow mingles with the taste that enter your mouth. Okay, let's see. It's hot. Let's try to make it a bit stronger. On the third brew, we were quite short with the first two times. Let's be a bit stronger now. Great. Now, a session can really last very long from this point on. Just you always have to check on your charcoal, add more charcoal to keep the heat strong enough to be able to boil your water. In this case, I don't want to spend so much time. We are going to come to a conclusion now, since we have brewed three times. But of course, with this tea in this small teapot, I can continue for many more brews. Just it would be a repeat. I don't want to bore you. So you've seen the way that traditional Chaozhou Gongfu Cha was performed, with an Yilu charcoal and Yusu Wei, so always checking on the fire, adding small quantities of water in order to always refresh the water. Remember, Louis said that if you overboil the water will lose its crisp taste. So adding a little bit of water in between brews helps to add freshness to the water. We've used also a pewter tea caddy, which is very useful for roasted teas. And you've seen a different way of preserving the heat in the teapot by keeping the teapot almost immerged into hot water. It's hot. And of course small porcelain cups and small sips and a beautiful chateau to make it look like little flowers. Thank you very much for watching, and see you some other time for another trashy session. Bye bye.